Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'll be demoing and reviewing the newly launched Pro Touch Air Shot. This is a Dyson Airwrap dupe and these are the results I got with this. I have used the curling barrel from Pro Touch on one side and Airwrap on one side, and I want you to guess which side is which. I know both look the same, but I just want you to guess before you watch the video. I'll just introduce what this is in brief and then we'll move on to the demo. Then I'll be comparing the curling barrel on both Dyson Airwrap and this one. And in the end, I'm just gonna tell my final thoughts on this product. So without further ado, let's get started. This is the newly launched Pro Touch Air Shot. It's an all-in-one hair multi-styler which can curl your hair, smooth your hair, dry your hair, give you a nice blowout and volume. It has an option of rotating the nozzle. It has a cool shot mode, it has a fan speed setting, temperature heat setting and an on and off switch. You can also easily clean the filter by removing the bottom part of it. It comes with different attachments. The first attachment is the air styling concentrator. This is just used to focus the airflow along your hair shaft. It also has this blow brush attachment which has a lot of bristles to grab your hair. You just have to brush it through your hair and it will give you the same blowout effect instead of using a separate dryer and a brush. Then the hero attachments are these auto wrap curling barrels. They have two barrels, each curling in different directions, and it uses Coanda effect similar to the Dyson Airwrap. It will just wrap your hair around with the air and it will give you nice blowout curls without using too much heat. At last, we have the Coanda anti-flyaway dryer. This attachment is used for taming down your flyaways, especially near the root area. It also comes with this brush teeth and it's perfect to be used after you're done heat styling your hair or straightening your hair. If you have missed few flyaways, then this attachment comes in handy. Now let me show you how to use this. Prepping your hair is so important. I recommend using a leave-in conditioner and a serum, and you can also use a heat protection spray just for additional heat protection. I'm using the Redken leave-in conditioner. I love this. Just gonna take a little bit because I don't want to weigh my hair down. Just going to apply it all over my hair. I recommend using it on damp hair. It just provides extra protection to your hair and it also hydrates your hair so that your blowout looks smooth and not dry. I also like to add a serum. I'm using the Olaplex number 7 bonding oil. It just adds a lot of smoothness and also protects from heat. Just brush it through so that it's distributed evenly. Now it's time to use the air shot. I tried this brush as soon as I received it, so there's some hair stuck in this, so don't mind that. Since I'm used to the Airwrap, I like it to be straight. It's going to rotate it. The attachment is very easy. You just have to fit in this. Sound should come. Tuck sound. That's when it's locked. If you have straight, slightly wavy hair, you can skip on this since you already have pretty smooth hair. So what you can do is you can use either this attachment or this attachment just to dry the root area. And on the ends, you can just use the curling barrels. That will work. But since I have curly hair, I need to smoothen out my entire hair just for long lasting and smooth results. I like that the wire is pretty long for this. I'm going to section my hair. Just sectioning it in four sections. If you have thick hair, then you can obviously take more sections. I think for me, four sections work. Almost forgot one more thing. So I also like to apply heat protection on each section as I'm styling it, just for added heat protection. If you have already added those two steps, you don't need to, but I like to do this. I'm going to set it on highest heat and highest speed and start to brush my hair from underneath first. While I'm brushing, I make sure to add tension so that the curls are really smoothened. And I do this from all the different directions, like underneath, from side, from top, just making sure my hair is dried completely with a smooth result. I like that it has this boar bristles. It really grabs the hair very well, especially if you have curly, kinky hair. You definitely need this to grab on your hair and add that tension. The bristles also grab my root better, so I like that. This is how the first section looks like. It needed me at least 10 to 15 passes to get this result. It has the metal thing inside, so it again helps to smoothen out your hair. Of course, there's slightly more heat when you're touching metal, but it helps to smoothen out your hair better. I love to spray extra heat protecting spray at the ends because my ends need it the most. One side is done and it has got it pretty straight with a very nice shine. Then I got this in mail. I was so excited. As soon as I opened the box, I used the blow brush attachment and I absolutely love the results. If you are following me on Instagram, you must have seen my story. This is what I got with this brush alone. It looks pretty good. I love these little waves I get. By the way, it's because of my hair type. If you don't have curly hair, then you might not get this. But you can definitely do this movement to get curls. So what you have to do is just do this and just leave it in and then put it off and remove it. That's how you get these kind of curls with this. But I did not even try to do that. This is just how my hair is. No matter how much I straighten it, I always get these waves at the bottom. But not complaining, because they look cute. I absolutely love the results. You can use this attachment on dry hair also, but for longer lasting results, I recommend using it on damp hair. I do see myself using this attachment for straightening my hair more often over my Dyson blow brush. That doesn't get my hair this smooth, especially in this humidity. So this attachment is definitely a win for me. By the way, removing the attachment is very easy. There's a lock switch over here. You just have to put it down and lift it. One more thing to keep in mind is that hold the attachment here, because this part gets pretty hot. So don't burn yourself. Let's move on to the curling barrel. I'm sure most of you are excited for this. I love the size of the barrel. It's perfect for long hair, medium hair. Take not very tiny sections, because I don't want very defined curl. I just want slight waves at the bottom. And I basically want that kind of a look. So I'm using the right arrow wala thing on my left side. The curls go, you know, in this outward direction. And on this side, I'll be using the Dyson Airwrap attachment, just so that you can see the difference. You can also use it on damp hair. By the way, I recommend doing it on damp hair for longer lasting results. But if you have curly hair like mine, first smoothen it out and then use it on dry hair. It is quite powerful. It easily wraps your hair around, and I keep it for around 10 seconds. And then I click on the cool short mode just to set the curl, and then switch off the device and then remove it. Oh my god, look at this curl. Don't remove it while it is on, otherwise you're gonna cause frizz. I really wish the cool short mode was part of the on and off switch, because for the Dyson Airwrap, for switching it on you have to pull it down, and for the cool short mode you just have to pull it up so that you can use the same button. Since the cool short mode is on top over here, this adds one more second extra for me to click on the cool short and then switch it off. Especially if you've used the Airwrap before, you would notice this difference. It's not a very big deal, you just have to get used to it. But the slight issue with it is that if you click on the cold short mode, it's blowing cool air, right? And then you leave the button and the air becomes hot again. So by the time you reach the off button, you get that 1 second of hot air, which is not really the most pleasant situation, because you want to set it on complete cool air. You don't want any hot air to touch after that. It's a very minute thing, but just wanted to mention it. One side is done. I'm gonna open my curls later once both sides are done. Let it sit this way for some time. I'm gonna be doing this side with the Dyson Airwrap. I'm gonna style my bangs later, okay? So just ignore this part. This is what I mean. This is the on-off switch for the Dyson Airwrap. And I just have to put it on like this. And for cool short mode, I have to pull it up higher. It just adds that convenience. Let me just open up my curls now. You guys, I've used wrong attachment on this. I should have used this kind of attachment. I've used the inward attachment. So dumb. I'm just gonna redo this section again. Okay, now it's looking better. Tabhi main sochu curls itne weird kyun lag rahe hai. Let me just open this part. Okay, now it's looking even. I honestly don't see a huge difference. Both of them look so good, but this side is just for half the price. I think lesser than half the price, because Dyson Airwrap is like 50,000. This is just 18,000. 18,000, I understand, it's still expensive, but comparatively, it's much cheaper. Okay, I want to style my bangs now. So I'm gonna take this attachment, this front sections. I'll keep it for a few seconds and cool short mode. Where is it? I'm not used to this. Okay, found it. Then cool short mode, and then soon I'm gonna put it off and slowly release it. And yeah, This is how I style my curtain bangs. Now, I'm the most excited for the flyaway attachment. This is the Kowanda anti-flyaway dryer. It's supposed to smoothen out your flyaways and I'm gonna use it the most because I don't have this attachment in the Airwrap. It came out later after I bought it. I love that it has this brush teeth given so you can hide your flyaways while brushing it and the air will flow in that particular direction. So there are two directions. You can, you know, change up the direction based on which side you're combing. It worked so much better than I expected. I mean, look at the almost no flyaway scene. Usually after I'm done styling my hair, I get a lot of flyaways. And usually I have to use the blow brush attachment only to, you know, smoothen it out. But I'm really happy with this. I can just use this. Even if I get a little bit of flyaway, I can just run it over. And I'm done. They have done such a wonderful job, you guys, for this. I'm so impressed. Just to add this final touch, I'm just gonna use a little bit of serum. Overall, I'm quite impressed with the ProTouch Air Shot. I think it's a great investment if you love salon style blowouts at home. It's very easy to use. Of course, there's a slight learning curve, which is true for any device, honestly. So the more you practice, the more you can get better at it and you can get this kind of blowouts easily at home. I love the power of it. If you ask me a comparison between the Airwrap and this, the power is almost the same. I didn't really notice any difference. The results I got are also same. If you ask me about the heat damage for both, then heat damage will be lesser compared to other devices in the market because this is styling using hot air. There's some metal to it, but mostly it is the hot air that is styling your hair, and the temperature for this is maximum 120 degrees Celsius. One more thing I like about this is that you can adjust the temperature setting, you can adjust the speed setting. The Airwrap uses 150 degrees Celsius, and Airwrap has something called as intelligent heat control, so every second it just regulates the heat so that it doesn't heat up too much. With ProTouch, I don't think something like that is there. At least it's not mentioned on their website. But if you just compare it with normal heating tools, the heat damage will be much lesser for this because first of all, it's styling on hot air. Then the maximum temperature of this is 120 degrees Celsius. So you're not really frying your hair. 120, trust me, it's not a lot. Overall, I would highly recommend it if you have the budget for it. If you're considering the Airwrap, but Airwrap is going out of your budget because it's 50,000, then you can blindly go for this. So that was it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. I upload new videos every week and I will see you in my next video. Bye.